Space, the boundary of human achievement, the new frontier.
It's just a cop.
Yeah, right. And the Earth is flat.
Treat your cough seriously with Robitussin CF Max. Nothing lasts longer and treats more symptoms for your cough, cold, and flu. Robitussin, because it's never just a cough.
In a few moments, you will have an experience which will seem completely real. It will be the result of your subconscious fears transformed to your conscious awareness. Warning. This tape must not be played by government personnel. It can be extremely harmful and result in severe trauma. You have 5 seconds to terminate this tape. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hold him. Now you listen to me, you hillbilly punk who thinks the world's still round. I'm here to tell you it's not. It's flat.
Lexi, tell us something interesting.
Okay. The Earth is flat, and a witch stole his pants.
Flat Earth expert Mark Sargent thinks the moon landing was a hoax.
Technically, the moon itself is a hoax.
Right, but betting with Sportsbet's new iPhone app?
I could do this standing on my head.
Thanks, gravity. Sportsbet's new iPhone app. It's foolproof.
Oh, hold on. I know how we're different. Do you believe the Earth is flat?
I know it's flat. I walk on it.
Holy shit.
The Earth is flat.
It's a flat world after all.
Smoke weed every day.
Broadcasting straight to you from a large spaceship currently at war with mainstream science. Meanwhile, I'm checking my microphone settings because I'm having to do a lot of things at the same time here. It's reported by machine. Meanwhile, the peanut gallery is excited that he might be able to fly again. We will see. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger in fiction. I'm your host, Mark Sargent, the creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure. Thousands of miles wide. Just Google Flat Earth Clues. If you can't find it, well, you're just not very good at the internet. And you're not doing well in life. Currently, this show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern. And yes, Caroline, if it is not, look at date. April 19th, 2022, that you are listening to a rerun. Quote of the day goes exactly like this semi-long thing. All right, follow along. A French journalist joined some French volunteer fighters in Ukraine. Those would be known as mercenaries. He said this: I had the surprise, and so did they, to discover that to be able to enter the Ukrainian army because, well, it's the Americans who are in charge. Adding that he and the volunteers almost got arrested by the American military, who asserted they were in charge. The journalist then was forced to sign a contract until the end of the war. And who is in charge? He said, it's the Americans. I saw it with my own eyes. Adding, I thought I was with the international brigades, and I found myself facing the Pentagon. My co-host, she's lovely, she's sassy, and she is one of the biggest Flat Earth rock stars ever. Karen B., what's going on, Karen?
Oh, you know, Mark, just, you know, fire drill the last second.
I know, we had to reboot. I had to reboot. Skype was doing an update, it turns out, and I couldn't join anything. I was getting rung. I couldn't pick up. And it's like, crap, we're going like Murphy's Law. So I had to reboot, and then I reinserting headlines. What a pain in the ass. Okay, that panic stuff out of the way. Let's get really right to it. Hey, Karen, Karen, being the reigning queen of Flat Earth, it must be hard to find Flat Earth friends. Do you know an easy way to find cool people like yourself and solid info about our stationary horizontal level plane?
Yes, why, that would be the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac and Clock app.
Yes, indeed. It's the perfect gift for friends, family, and complete strangers. I rewrote that because David's version, well, he was a little long-winded. And that's coming from me, who is also a little long-winded. By the way, what's your sweatshirt say?
My sweatshirt says, Unveiling This Realm.
Sweet. Nice.
It's custom.
Hey, you know, watch the feature video every day for 2 weeks and see what happens. It'll be the best $2.99 you've ever spent. Don't forget, you can also find this program on BitChute and Brighty on Rockfin and Rumble. YouTube is not the end of Flat Earth. It is just the beginning. I'm really surprised that YouTube actually doesn't censor all that stuff out when we talk about it. It's like, we're going to mention your direct competition. They don't really care, I don't think, because they're owned by Google, who owns.
They don't care because everybody's watching the show on their platform. So
right. Yeah.
They wouldn't care.
Okay, we have special shout-outs this week. Obviously, huge shout-out to Flat Earther Stephen Carpenter of the Deftones. I got a chance to meet him last Friday. I went out on his day off. The tour bus came in. So they just started their tour. They went to Portland, and they came to Seattle second day of the tour. And they played on Saturday. I met with him on Friday, got a chance. I went down early. Hadn't been downtown Seattle really since the pandemic. And we hung out together. I went to lunch, hung out at his hotel room, came back to his hotel room, you know, hung out on the street. Met some of his roadies, friends, and it was great. Hung out and talked shop for 8 hours, went by so fast. And I've learned more about him. He is a really, really cool dude. I mean, down to earth, solid rocker, you know, in his blood. He is, and he's not one of those, you know, they're rock stars. There's cliche rock stars, and there's this guy. This guy is built for the long haul. He will be, you know, if the world kept moving along, he would be rocking out until doomsday. He is built like that. It is really, really great. Other bands burn out, but you can tell he's going to keep doing his thing. And it was a privilege to spend time with him. I'm so happy.
So, that's awesome. I'm jealous. And I'm upset that I didn't get a picture of you two together.
Okay, first off, and part of it was my fault because I bring a cell phone with me only in case I get a flat tire. I never use my cell phone for anything but phone stuff, and I hardly ever use it. It's sitting over there doing nothing. But he actually messaged me later and said, oh, we didn't get a selfie. Could you come back down? It's like, oh, wow. Seattle on a Saturday, leaving from Whidbey Island. Really tough. Plus, I had an interview with the University of Indiana that morning, so it wasn't going to play out. But it's all right. We'll, you know, don't worry. We will, you know, it's not like what, he can't call me at any given time. Yeah, I know there's a picture opportunity missed, but I don't feel too bad because, as you know, I am the opposite of photogenic, if there's a term. Karen, on the other hand, she never takes a bad picture. So,
well, that's not true, but doesn't matter about being photogenic or not. I wanted a picture of you guys together.
You wanted the picture more than anything. So he's going to get to meet you when he's out in Atlanta, which is going to be really, really cool. In fact, let's
mention, I'm going to get a picture with Stefan. Don't get it twisted. I'm totally. I'm be sure. Like, get in here. We're having a photo shoot.
Awesome. You're going to love him. So support the Flat Earth cause and get the coolest hoodies ever. Go to the strong.family. Also, in fact, I'm pretty sure we've got the link in chat because I think I put it in there. Let's go up to the top because I'm going to read off the – did I do that? No, I didn't. Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah, I did. Okay. So the Deftones tour. So that's the first link. So I'm every week until the tour ends, I'm going to let you guys know where he's going to be. So the next three events before the next week's show, he's going to be in Los Angeles. That's the big one, from what I understand. That's going to be huge.
Oh, yeah.
Down at the Greek Theater. That's going to be April 20th. Then they go out to Las Vegas.
What do you think? 420? A Deftones show on 420 in L.A.? You think that's going to be a big show? You think?
Oh, I think so. I think so. And by the way, I was reading through his wiki. You know, I didn't actually look up his wiki entry until recently. And, you know, his Flat Earth reference is in there in his wiki entry.
Yeah.
You know, that he's Flat Earth. And I don't want to ruffle feathers, but it was like – but and they asked Chino about it, the lead singer. And Chino said, well, it's probably because of all the dopey smokes, right?
Yeah, like, but you know what? I read that. I don't think that's a real quote. That can't be real. Chino said it, he was joking, and then they put it in there like it was real.
That's probably what it was. So anyway, April 22nd, they're going to be in Las Vegas, Nevada. And then April 23rd, right afterward, they're going to jump down to – that's going to be a to Phoenix, and then and then Denver, Colorado, the night before our next show is going to be April 25th. They're going to be at the Ball Arena, so very, very cool. They'll have four shows between now and then. Very, very cool. And then he's going to run into you. Then they do Albuquerque, Memphis, Houston. Oh, two shows in Memphis. Nice. Irving, Atlanta is going to be May 6th for you. So
yes, May 6th. That's
and right. Actually, we'll see. Because if they leave San Antonio, well, how long it takes to get from San Antonio to Atlanta? But he'll definitely get there a day early. So hopefully, you'll get to run into him. All right. One other thing I want to mention, and this is probably good because then I can throw in the rest of the headlines during the break because I didn't get all the headlines. Sorry, you know, because we were rushing. Because I already put the headlines.
But the shout-outs, announcements, you mean?
We got the shout outs, but we're going to do some of the headlines. But before that, I wanted to mention that there's a couple things that have been bugging me recently. And one of them, of course, is, in fact, it's so funny during the, when we were doing the pre-show, I got another email, just got another one. You know what it was called, Karen? You know what it's called? Snake venom. Yep.
Oh God.
Yep. We will discuss that later because I told you guys last week, stop sending me the snake venom links. Please stop. Here's an Apple podcast. It's called Think About It. I mean, there's now spinoff videos of the original video for the snake venom. No, that's not what I want to talk about. The ones that are starting to get under my skin right now because of snake venom, I get it, right? I get that. No, what's getting me recently is that people – and the what triggered me just recently is one of our dedicated listeners was asking me, and it's not the first one I've gotten a number of them, that is Elon Musk going to save us after he buys Twitter and removes censorship? Not kidding you. Not kidding you. It's like, okay, one, I don't care. First off, it is a distraction story. Elon's not going to buy Twitter and drain the swamp. It's almost like the draining the swamp version. It's almost like a mini Trump thing, all right? The other thing is, even if he bought it, who the hell cares? It's just Twitter. It's not the social media banner is massive in scale. Him buying Twitter means nothing. It's like some people's like, well, what are you going to do? Reinstate Trump's account? That's the goal of Twitter? No. No, it's never going to happen. It's never, ever going to happen. So I want to read to you really quick what I wrote to him, because I'm trying to give you guys some perspective here, which is, so I tried to remind him. I go, remember my video calling him out? Because I called Elon out. It was in 2018, right? Back when the New York Post said that he was a complete and total fraud, right? Long before anything has started. And then in 2019, I dedicated a solid section to him in my book, the chapter called Enemies of the State, right? Okay, I'm trying to calm down here. Is he a possible loose cannon in the deep state? Sure, why not? I'm not going to shoot that down. But look at his track record of, quote unquote, things I am going to do, right? These are the things he said he was going to do. I'm going to tell you if he did them or not. Ready? Real fast. I'm going to take tourists around the moon in 2018. No. I'm going to build a super plane that can go from the United States to China in 2 hours. No. I'm going to build an underground bullet train from Los Angeles to San Francisco. No. Didn't even start that one. Didn't start any of this. I'm going to install super solar generators after the Puerto Rico hurricane left them all powerless. No. I'm going to save the kids in the cave with the high-tech mini sub that I didn't design. No. I'm going to beat Putin in hand-to-hand combat for the fate of Ukraine. No. No. He didn't buy... And of course, the most recent. I'm going to buy Twitter to remove censorship. No.
Right.
Look, Elon didn't create Tesla Motors. He didn't create PayPal. And he once said that SpaceX is real because it looks so fake. Right? He's been faking space for years, and we've got people from our community letting me know. It's like, oh, he could be the one. It's like, no, he's not Tony Stark. Right? I want to beat that one into the ground. He's not. Nobody is Tony Stark. Robert Downey Jr. is not. Tony Stark is fictional. It doesn't. He's not that guy. So stop sending me emails saying that Elon Musk is this. You know what it is? It's like they're tying him to – I'm not kidding you. It's almost through osmosis. They are tying him to Tesla directly. Everybody knows in our community that the actual Nikola Tesla was the guy. You know, if he would have lived now, yes, he could have actually been Tony Stark if Nikola Tesla was alive now. But he died years ago, decades and decades ago. Right? Mm-hmm. He was friends with Mark Twain. That's how long ago it was.
Right.
And for some reason, they think because he bought Tesla Motors, he has now channeled the spirit of Nikola Tesla. He's now that guy. Oh, God, he is an utter and complete fraud. Just drives me insane. So stop asking that.
Yeah, he's a total tool.
He's a total tool. And it does not make any sense that you would say this now. I mean, come on. Our people, right? He's been faking the Tesla Roadster in space. That was him. Where's the disconnect? Where did you go from a complete fake Tesla Roadster in space to he's the good guy and he's going to clean up everything because he's going to buy Twitter and remove all the censorship? How did that happen? How did people just forget all that? Oh, okay. All right. I'm done.
That's fine.
I'm going to delete. Sorry, Ronald Lee.
There's
you're
a really good clip of Elon Musk that Jaron likes to play where he's in an interview and he keeps looking at his computer screen and he's like, I forget where to look. So it makes it look like I'm looking at the camera.
He's such a freaking tool. The only thing I'm going to say is he was in the right place at the right time. And there's a wonderful video that David likes to send out with links, because people quote Elon Musk more and more and more now. And David Weiss will send out this little link, which is a little 6-minute video that shows it's like, look, the man is a complete fraud since minute one. The only thing he's done is he rewrites the corporate charter after he gets involved. It's like, how did he go from a guy that bought Tesla? You know, he was part of the PayPal team before it went a IPO, but he didn't design anything. How did he become all of a sudden the richest man in the world? How did he jump past Bill Gates and Bezos? How did that even happen? He is a government stooge. He is a tool, and I've got to stop talking about him. All right, I'm done. The peanut gallery is probably saying, all right, talk about it, something else. Okay, let's get to the freaking headlines, shall we?
Yes, let's get to the freaking headlines.
Let's get the freaking headlines. All right, before that, let's do a quick summary, quick recap, because a lot has happened. And I hate to do this every week, but it's kind of like when you're binge-watching a show. So it's like previously on Strange World, in case you forgot, 6-7 days ago. Okay, quick summary. The invasion starts. The U.S. and the U.K. keep their Green Berets and Special Air Service troops. That's also known as the SAS. And guys, so you don't have to ask me. You should probably look it up. So they keep them in Ukraine as advisors, otherwise known as mercs. Russia sees through this and blows most of them up with missiles. The U.S. and the U.K. then bomb a petroleum facility as well as a nearby town on the other side of the Russian border. Notice I said the other side of the Russian border, actually in Russia. This is stuff you're not going to – mainstream media is not going to touch this. Russia says, oh, I'll see that pointless attack, and I'll raise you by pounding Mariupol into dust, and I'm going to capture some of your senior advisors, but we're not going to tell anybody. We're going to tell you, but you're not going to release it on the media because you can't, because they're not supposed to be there. Again, that's the whole point. Right? Nobody's supposed to be in any of these places. They're just taking shots at each other, and no one's going to talk about it. All right, fine. You're going to take our senior advisors. The UK and the US decide to take it up a notch, and they blow up a Russian destroyer. And then the Black Sea, which is, by the way, why the show is called Shot Through the Bow instead of Shot Across the Bow. Shot Across the Bow means you miss. It's just a warning shot. And there was no warning. No. We're playing for keeps. In response, Russia decides to probe UK defenses and drop a missile outside Britain's largest air base, and the mainstream media is downplaying or flat out ignoring all of what I just said because it is not officially happening. But it will. Everyone caught up? All right, let's go to the links. Here we go. All right, the first one. And you have to keep track of the time for me, Peanut and Karen. So this is from China Daily, of all places. Airstrikes in Russia stir anger in Moscow. What airstrikes in Russia? What? Russia on Thursday accused Ukraine of carrying out a helicopter strike on a border town in its territory in Russia and warned that it may deploy nuclear weapons close to the Baltic states and Scandinavia if Finland and Sweden join NATO. That's the opening paragraph. We're not going to even go any further than that one on this, which is like, okay, first, not Ukraine helicopters. No. That's us. That is us and the British. The Ukraine Air Force is gone. Completely gone. And by the way, so is their Navy, but we'll get to that later. All right, moving on. Next one down. The next one, which is the part of the quote of the day, and this is from, as it's loading, from Tap News. Americans are in charge of the war, says French journalist who returned from Ukraine. Wow. Why aren't we seeing this in the American media? Why is this only a French journalist thing? That's because French journalists went over there. The American military guys were yelling at him. He's like, wait, why are you guys doing all this? Why isn't it Ukrainians? And like, shut up. So he came home and talked about it. Wonderful. Really, really great. Let's move on. Next one down. Is that third one down? Is it Nordic Neighbors?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's get into this. This is from Market Watch. This is the American side. I love how the head of Sweden and Finland look like an ABBA reunion tour. The lady in Sweden, she's the blonde lady in blue, and the lady in the all black leather ensemble to match her hair is from Finland. And what's happening there is Sweden and Finland are not part of NATO. Norway is, but not Sweden and Finland. And now they are, the headline is, Nordic neighbors Sweden and Finland take key steps toward prospective NATO membership. Straight out of Helsinki, European nations, blah, 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 reached important stages. Basically, they're trying to join NATO. And if you look, let's see here. Officials said Russia would respond with such a move with retaliatory measures that would cause military and political consequences for Helsinki and Stockholm. Why? Well, I'll tell you why. Because Sweden, they don't care so much. But it's a package deal. Remember, this is the ABBA reunion tour. So it's a package deal. So Sweden, they're just in the middle. There's Norway, and then there's Sweden in the middle, and then there's Finland on the left. But Finland shares a border with Russia that's 830 miles long. That's bad. Russia's like, yeah, we're not sharing a border with any more NATO people. It's not going to happen. we're just not doing it. There's going to be a buffer there, and that's going to be it. And they said, if this happens, you know, if you guys actually get to the point where Finland is going to come into NATO, yeah, we're going to roll in there. And that is absolutely, in fact, let's go to the next one, shall we? The next one is, oh, look, what happened? Washington Post, Russia threatens to move nukes into Baltic region in Finland if Sweden join NATO. And there's the, you know, ABBA again on the screen. They're sitting there in the podium again. They're almost like they're daring each other. It's like, I'll go if you go. Okay, let's both join NATO. It'll be great. Finland has about 20, 25,000 active military, and they got a couple hundred thousand in reserve. But Russia knows that there's a little caveat, which is you can't be considered for NATO membership if any other army is occupying even some of your territory, if it's contested. So if Russia just rolls in, I don't know, 5-10 miles into the border and sets up a little way station there, fires a few missiles, that's it. The NATO membership is then declined. It's kind of like trying to get insurance. If you have you're talking to an insurance rep for your house and you've got a little fire on the kitchen stove, if there's some flames coming out of a pan, the insurance guy's going, yeah, you probably should put that out first before we actually insure the house. You know, just saying. That's what they're going to do. So that's how it's going to go. And this is going to be the next big move, which is Ukraine. And by the way, don't think that Russia won't do it, because this is what happened with Ukraine. Ukraine was like, oh, yeah, let's join NATO. And Russia's like, don't do it. We're going to roll in there. Don't you freaking do it. And it's like, yeah, let's join NATO. And Russia's like, screw it. We're going in. And they go in. So don't think that this isn't going to happen with Finland. This is absolutely. If Finland joins, they won't even make it to the vote. They won't even get to the petition part. If Russia even gets word, it's like, oh, yeah, they're writing out their application now. No, they're going in. Because they can. It'd be super easy to do. It's not like Ukraine. All right, moving on. 3 minutes. Okay. 3 minutes. We'll end before the break. We'll end with this one, which is the follow-up question from Newsweek magazine with a lovely warp picture. What would happen if Russia invaded Finland? Experts weigh in. Well, nothing good. Let's put it that way. Looking at the article here, both countries have a long and often difficult history with Russia, marred by war and mutual distrust, blah, blah, blah. And if you scroll down, they're basically saying that it would not go well, but NATO technically couldn't do anything because they're not part of NATO yet. So Russia would probably just roll in and occupy certain cities and make things very, very difficult. And then there would be a question for the rest of the world. It's like, okay, fine. We wouldn't do much when it came to Ukraine. Would we do anything for Finland? Would we do anything, you know, if the leaders, if the, not picking here, but if the female leaders, you know, did an impassioned plea, not like Greta Thunberg. Where's Greta from, by the way? Do you remember what country she's from?
I don't know.
Austria? Peanut, look that up. Where's Greta from? So if these women actually get on a podium and you know, start with the tears, it's like, oh, it's so horrible. Oh, no. You know, then maybe possibly. But yeah, Finland is a big, big key thing. And the reason I'm bringing this up, I'm going to watch the clock as I do this, is because Russia's not taking the bait right now. We're trading punches behind the scenes, these shadow punches, which nobody has seen. But Russia's not taking the bait. And we'll talk about that after the break, but they're not. Normally, Russia would take the bait, and we could get them to come in, but they're not doing it when it comes to the little stuff. But when it comes to Finland, that's a whole other thing. That's a region. That's a territory. Russia's like, no, we're not letting you expand anymore. You've expanded NATO huge amounts since the fall of the Soviet Union. We're not letting you do it anymore. So if you do Finland, we're going to take Finland, and that'll be it. And we might even take Sweden too, but I doubt it. Sweden. What's in Sweden anyway? I mean, I was in Sweden.
She's from Sweden.
Oh, Greta's from Sweden?
Yep.
Oh, even better. Oh, even better. Because if Russia does that, I bet you she comes out of her tour or whatever she's doing. And because she does speaking engagements now at places.
And then she tells Putin, how dare you?
How dare you? All right. When we come back, we'll read the rest of the headlines. Hopefully we can finish this stuff off. And then we'll take your phone calls. I won't read the phone number. Hopefully the music's going to kick in. And we'll be back in 3 minutes. See, we recovered pretty nicely. all things considered.
He's all right.
Is Stephen playing tonight? Is he listening tonight?
No, he's playing tomorrow. Tomorrow's okay. 4:20. It's the big show.
All right.
You are now tuned into the truth frequency.
Your protection from deception. TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 2 of 4. It's you and me and the lovely Karen B. And yeah, you know what? That was Joe Jackson stepping out from his album.
Night and Day.
Oh, were you doing some ASMR just then with your double mic thing?
A little bit.
Yeah, nice. For those of you, yeah, listening on TFR, you don't know that Karen's got a double mic set up. So if you're listening in stereo, you can hear her out of both of your ears.
Yes, if you're listening in your headphones, you can hear me on one side and then in the other.
Yes, indeed. Okay, headlines. I got them all pasted in. Let us knock them out. Okay, next one down, which is... Dun, 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 dun. Oh, yeah, so we ended... Let's transition. We ended with what would happen if Russia decided to invade Finland, which they will, followed by, oh, hey, look, NATO warships arrive in the Baltic Sea. Wonder why. A group of NATO vessels are set to carry out exercises in the region. Didn't see that on mainstream media. That's an RT reminder. If you haven't, you know, check out RT.com, otherwise known as RussiaToday.com, because, well, you may not be able to eventually. So NATO warships gather in Baltic Sea for, you know, various things. In fact, they're from how many different countries? Flagships from Netherlands, Denmark, Germany, and the UK. And then the other one is Norwegian, Belgian, German, Estonian, British, and Dutch. So just sending a few up there. Why would they be doing this? Well, let's go to the next one down. Next one down is... cracks me up. This is from the Jerusalem Post. I love their media sometimes. Russia warns of risk of unintended clashes with NATO in the Arctic. Maybe. If we happen to blow something or yours up, you know what? We didn't mean it. It was an accident.
We told you we were dropping nukes.
Yeah. So if all of a sudden some of your forces go missing, What are you going to do? It just happens. So, yeah, Russia expressed concern about non-Arctic NATO member states being involved in military activities in the Arctic. Saying that it risks causing unintentional clashes with NATO forces in the region. Uh-huh. Yep. Okay, moving on. So just to let you know what's happening up there. But while we're on the issue of ships, let's go to what we said, because you guys were probably listening in my recap. It's like, wait a minute, the recap, blowing up a ship, that's not part of it. Well, yes. So first one is, this is from RT Today. I love this. So RT, and this was April 13th at pushing midnight. I don't know if it was our time. Russian warship seriously damaged by explosion. An alleged ammunition explosion incident. Some random ammunition dump just blew up in one of their ships.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. Cruiser suffered serious damage. Next one down. And they weren't blaming anybody. This is the opposite of a false flag, right? Whereas mm-hmm. Russians are like, it just happened, right? Meanwhile, right. Our media says, oh, hey, Ukraine... Ukraine's Navy fired something and hit a Russian destroyer, a flagship, and they abandoned the flagship. That's from the Wall Street Journal. It's like, okay, all right, I see what's happening here. So Ukraine's taking credit for it, which is interesting because Ukraine hasn't had a navy in about a month. Your navy's all gone. So what hit it?
Exactly.
Could it have been the Americans or the British? This,
exactly.
Yeah. So next one down, which is, if I got the ones right, this is from RT. And again, this is April 14th, next day, right? Midday next day. Fire aboard Russian warship contained. The cruiser, the Moskva, remains afloat with its main missile armaments unaffected, said the Ministry of Defense from Russia. Well, you got it handled. Not a problem, right? Good, let's go to the next one down, which is same Russia today. 5 hours later, Russian flagship sinks, says the military. So what happened? The missile cruiser went down to the Black Sea while being towed to port. So that fire, yeah, you didn't have that contained at all, did you? Yep. So what have we learned from this part? We've learned that both sides are going to lie about everything. The Russians did not want to blame the Americans because, well, how could they? The Americans aren't involved, right? So they were just going to say, no, it was an accident. And then the Americans say, oh, the Ukrainians blew them up. What'd you blow them up with? The Ukrainian Navy's gone. No, it doesn't matter. Nobody remembers that. So we go to the last story of this chain. Just want to remind people how things happen. So when I say, this is from, I think, a UK, from the Mirror in the UK, when they run a story that says, oh, hey, there was a big fireworks storage unit that just mysteriously exploded near their biggest Air Force base. And even though witnesses said they saw something coming from the sky before that explosion started, do you think it was a fireworks facility? Because you can only use that one once, right? That's one cover story you can only use one time.
Right. No,
that is the Russians going, okay, we could play this game. We're gonna place one right about here. And what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do, Britain? We didn't forget about your SAS. You know, you're gonna blame the Russians? You can't blame the Russians, because it's like, why would the Russians be attacking Britain? Britain's not involved in Ukraine, are they? No. Clever. Just freaking clever all over the place. Anyway, wonderful coincidence. But again, that story's not going to go anywhere because the Russians are smart enough. They're not going to say, look what we did. Nope, they can't. So great. So yeah, behind the scenes, this stuff has already started. We're just waiting for it. Okay, next one down. And I know we're past some of Peanut's messages. Obvious ones. This one's from also from RT. And that is nations that owe Russia money for some of their energy stuff. They're not paying. Shocker. No, nobody's. It's like, don't send them any money. It's not just because they want it in rubles. They're like, yeah, just delay the payments as long as they can. If you're going to eventually get in a fight with the landlord, you know, if you're going to beat him up in the parking lot, there's no reason to hand him a rent check ahead of time. That's the only analogy I could come up with. All right, next one down. So we're going to go lucky or unlucky. And let me know in Karen's chat if you've heard some of these before, because I don't think we have, because some are fairly new. First one's from RT again, which is tennis ace says vaccine reaction could account for poor results. Ugo Humbert made the comments after crashing out of the Monte Carlo Masters this week. French tennis star says doctors have suggested a bad reaction to his shot last year may be a possible reason for his slump in form. Did all the possible tests, found nothing. It was crazy. But then 10 days after my shot in Toronto, I played a lot, but after 45 minutes or an hour, I had cramps everywhere. At the end of the season, it was very tough for me to practice. After an hour, I was exhausted. So, yeah. And it's, again, fantastic shot of him in the blue there.
Yeah.
that picture was taken probably 15 minutes after he got the shot or his booster. All right, next one down. He's lucky, but again, lucky or unlucky, he's lucky. He's alive. Great. Good for him. Good
for
you.
The doctor said there might be a connection with the vaccine, but it was useless to keep searching because we don't exactly know enough about the vaccine yet.
You know, Karen, that's funny you'd mention that. I saw that little quote too, and I thought, you don't know enough. You've given out 11 billion doses.
But you're going to inject it into people five freaking times. But we don't know enough about it.
Yeah, you don't know enough. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, next one. Next one is a Twitter link, and this is from, when was this tweet? Was this tweet
April 11th, 2022?
You think it's a repeat. It might be a repeat, but you know what? It bears repeating anyway, because I didn't see her in the hospital bed. Nelly Korda, number two female golf player in the world. She is done. She is probably retired due to blood clots. She is 23. So, hey, you know what? She's still alive. Good for her. Moving on. Next one down. This one caught some people by surprise, but American media hasn't been touching it. UK did, because it's a UK thing. Tim Feerick, F-E-R-I-C-K, from the band Dance Gavin Dance. He's a bassist. Died suddenly. I believe he was 32. If not mistaken, they're not saying exactly what he died suddenly of, but because we've heard the term suddenly or unexpectedly so many times, I bet you can probably guess what it was.
Right.
So, yeah. Yeah. Tim Gavin, bassist, Ben. And last but not least, and this is not lucky or unlucky, this is just something I predicted a while ago, which is from the Sun that's out in Britain, and a guy that on the gurney that kind of looks like me, which is weird. Warning to anyone who's had COVID over a sudden and deadly side effect. Even those who didn't have an illness severe enough to be hospitalized are at risk. Can you guess what it's going to be? Research recently published in the journal Nature Medicine, but conducted, notice how they specify this, conducted before vaccines were widely available, warned long-term effects could be seen in the heart and vascular system. These include cardiac arrest, which is when the heart suddenly grinds to a halt. It needs urgent medical attention, including CPR at the scene. Without this, a person will die. In case you didn't know what a heart attack is. The study found people who had battled COVID had a 2.5 times higher risk of cardiac arrest in the year following than those who had not the bug. Uh-huh. And there you go. Because of that article and articles that will follow, you will never be able to talk to anybody that's gotten the shot.
You know, they have really done a good job of taking what is your body's natural response to having toxins in it, which is to expel toxins and excrete toxins, which is what happens when you get a cold or a flu. All your excretory organs go into overdrive and you're excreting mucus and whatnot and whatever sweat to get rid of whatever toxins your body has ingested. You know, that's basically what it is. And so people who get quote unquote COVID, which is a detox response, are people who are regularly ingesting things that are not good for them. Like they have bad eating habits, or they drink a lot, or they're ingesting a lot of toxins. So yeah, those people are already unhealthy. So yeah, they're going to have 2.5 times higher risk of cardiac arrest, because these are generally unhealthy people who are going through severe detoxes. And this is the game that they're playing. And they've done a brilliant job of brainwashing everybody. Everybody believes it. Everybody buys into it 100%. And it's really shocking how they've done it.
Yeah. Again, the conformity builds empires. And we know a lot of sheep, a lot of them. I mean, I know them in my own freaking family and friends and ex-coworkers and everyone but two of my ex-girlfriends, which is depressing. Which means I'm not going to get in back with any of those girls again. All right. Let's go on. Let's switch over to what I mean is you know full well, it's like, even though I'm not a big fan of the whole shedding thing, which we're not supposed to talk about a lot, I would, you know, if I couldn't date someone who's gotten the shot now. Not gonna roll those dice.
No.
I don't care what you believe. It's like, there's one thing to roll the dice, and then the next thing it's like, I'm not even deep kissing. I wouldn't even recommend that. Seriously. Just general any bodily fluids. All right, let's get off of that. All right, let's switch over to the other side. Let's not forget about Taiwan, because we haven't ramped up with that yet, and that's still simmering. So the next one down, you remember last week where Nancy Pelosi said that she was thinking of going to Taiwan, and China says, oh, hell with that. If you go to that, you're recognized Taiwan as an independent nation, and they're not. They're part of ours. We own them.
Right.
So Nancy said, fine, I'm not going. So instead, this is from the National Review, senators, I want the first one, right? U.S. lawmakers. U.S. lawmakers arrive in Taiwan. A group of six U.S. lawmakers arrived in Taiwan on Thursday in an unannounced two-day visit. Well, that's because they didn't want Chinese knowing amid growing tensions between Beijing and Washington. All right, let's skip past that to the reaction one, which is right below it. And that is from National Review. Senators pay surprise visit to Taiwan, drawing China's fury. the delegation included, of course, Senator Lindsey Graham from your neck of the woods, Bob Menendez, Ben Sasse, Rob Portman, and Ronnie Jackson. And the visit comes after House Speaker Nancy Pelosi canceled a planned trip to the island because she backed down. And she said, I'm not going to go. I didn't realize this. She's not going to go because she caught the virus. Mm-hmm. And the Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi had previously called her visit a red line for U.S.-China relations. Oh, it's still coming. But we're not there yet. We're
so massaging. Instead of sending her, they just sent other people.
Yeah, they just send other people. Yeah, I know, because it's like, because those other people don't count for anything. I mean, they don't count right, as much as her, but they do count. All right. And then let's just get to the last ones. We'll skip over the map of people that are I don't think I put the map in this one anyway, which is let's get to the CD stuff. So the day after our last show, so last Wednesday, the article says CDC to extend federal transportation mandate for additional 15 days. So he said, oh, yeah, you know what? For planes and trains and boats and buses, we're going to push this thing out to May 3rd. Well, that didn't last very long because the next one down was getting page not found. Are you getting page not found?
Yeah, I couldn't even open the last link.
Shoot. Well, you know what? I'm just gonna rattle off. You guys know what happened since then. So what happened was a federal judge came in and said, yeah, the CDC doesn't have the authority to do that. But basically what they said was they don't have a reason to do it. They just pushed it out to May 3rd, and a federal judge said, why? They said, just because? It's like, yeah, no good. Denied. And so immediately most of the airlines dominoed, and most of the airports that went along with it, with the exception of Chicago and a couple others. And they say, in fact, there are some wonderful videos where people are in air in mid flight. And they were so, the airlines were so excited to get this thing going that they called their pilots and they said, pilots, announce in mid flight that they can take their masks off.
Yeah.
And they did. And most people were just thrilled. Just thrilled. But there was the occasional ones that said, like you mentioned, Karen, that said, oh, no, I'm going to keep wearing them anyway. Or my kid doesn't have the shot yet, therefore you should be respectful of them and keep your mask on. Nobody did. Right. It's like, screw that. We're not doing it. We'll have to see how that goes. And then the last article was that Uber and and Lyft and all the others, they said, yeah, we don't, you know, the drivers don't have to do it, the passengers don't have to do it. And so here we are 2 years later, and we're back to where we were 2 years ago, kind of, but not really. So with that, Karen, and you and I haven't talked about this, but I'm going to tell you right now, because I've got you on right now. You know what this means?
What does it mean?
That means I'm coming to freaking Flattoberfest is what it means.
Woo!
Yep. Let's plug Flattoberfest for the rest of the segment.
Yeah, buddy.
So, because it was ticking me off anyway. I mean, the airports, as you know, I didn't go to Flattoberfest last year because I did not absolutely trust the testing processes and the mask stuff when it came to the airports. What I didn't want to do is get stuck in an area. It's like where all of a sudden somebody's temperature gunning my head, because I've seen that when I came down to see you in 2020, I was in the Seattle airport and they were heat gunning people's heads. They were going up to Canada. It's like, what the hell are you doing? And what happens if you come? What happens if you just ran to the gate and you're running hot anyway? Yeah, it's exactly. Not going to let you on. And what if you had a family with you? Like, dad can't get on, but the kids can. Or what if little Billy can't? What if he can't get on? What the hell happens? Anyway, the point is that's all done now. So tell us, Karen, what's happening? Oh my God! You know what I haven't done?
What?
Peanut should probably remind me. You know what? I didn't do the meetups.
I know. You didn't do meetups. You didn't talk about truth smacks.
Sorry, I was distracted.
Are we going back to do that?
Sorry. The distraction. No, we tried, but you ranted instead. Yeah, I'm sorry. I was so worked up that I forgot about that. I was all over the place. Well, that's what happens when you get a break connection. It wasn't going to be perfect. Okay, you know what? Truthsmacks.com. Yep, spreading truth one delicious morsel at a time. Karen might have the QR code up on her screen. This is the last bag that I have in the house. So if you're listening out there, please send me more Truth Smacks because I work for Trail Mix, apparently. Truth Max, Trail Mix Supreme. Wonderful. In normal and minty flavor. Very, very good. I love it. Okay, sorry. And the meetups. Sorry, guys. I apologize. But at least I got to them. So the meetups real fast because we can tie this in. We'll segue this into your Flattoberfest. So there's a meetup in Windham, New Hampshire, instead of Salem, this Sunday, the 24th, starting at 2 p.m. at Griffin Park, 101 Range Road, Windham, New Hampshire. Dress warm. Look for a blue dot. You will find us. To RSVP, call or text Kobe at 603-339-9830. Also, there are five meetups happening this weekend around Florida. They are Titusville, Fort Lauderdale, Orlando, Okeechobee, and Sarasota. The schedules can all be found at
FlatEarthFestivals.com.
Yes, indeed. And then sometime after that, down the road in October, which I haven't made the promos for, but I will. Especially now that I'm going. I mean, really, that's all that matters. Tell us. I mean, now that it's going, anyone that was hesitating to go, you might as well just book it now because I will be there. I do not know what I'm doing if I'm going, but I'm very excited now to do this. I'm just more excited to walk through a normal airport. I haven't done the airport thing in 2 years now, a year and a half. Okay, Karen, Flattoberfest.
All right, Flattoberfest 2022 is October 22nd and 23rd in Greenville, South Carolina. It is two full days at the Greenville Shrine Club Event Center where we had Flattoberfest 2020, and we also had Solar Return there. It is a great place, a great venue. We get lots of freedom there. They love us there, and we're going to have a blast. We are also going to be renting the park across the street on the 21st, the day before the event, so everybody can get together, have a meetup outdoors, and we can do early registration for the event. So it's basically a 3-day event that we have planned for October. And Mark Sargent's going to be there.
Damn right, I'm going to be there. No, seriously, I'm very happy that all the mandates and everything is now gone out the freaking window. You know, the only thing would stop me from going would actually stop the entire convention, which is if all of a sudden we were restricted from flying entirely because of some weird
some more bullshit.
If WrestleMania 3 breaks out, then yes, that's what I'm going to call it, by the way. WrestleMania 3 breaks out, then yes. But
I like to think of it as like the big boss fight, like in the video game. It's like the big boss fight, right?
It is. It is the big boss fight. This is, and for me, you're younger than I am, but I mean, you got to remember, this is something that's been preached to us for since the early '80s, and where if you don't remember, seriously, watch the movie. I know for anyone that's under the age of 40, watch the 19 early '80s Red Dawn with Patrick Swayze and Charlie Sheen, and all the other crowd. It's a great, it's a great, one of the greatest propaganda movies of all time. Greater than Rocky IV, greater than Rambo, greater than all that stuff. It was, again, spoiler alert, when in the first 5 minutes you're sitting in a high school classroom of this movie and Russian paratroopers land, you're in a high school classroom in Colorado and Russian paratroopers land and just start shooting up the school, you're in for a ride. And after that, people just, the Russian stuff, people hated Russians after that, or they were scared of them. Okay. I think that's it. I don't think I've missed anything. I got the meetups. we plugged Flattoberfest, and I'm really excited to...
Yeah, but I still have one more thing to say about Flattoberfest. I'm not quite done plugging it, though, yet, okay? Yes. One more thing, one more detail, one more very important detail is that the tickets are on early bird sale for the month of April. So all the way up until April 30th, which is 11 more days because today's the 19th, the tickets are on sale for $122.33 instead of $155.11. So they're discounted right now. So I know I don't have the whole schedule of everybody who's going to be there, but you know Mark Sargent's going to be there. Cammy Nodell, Bob Nodell, Zach Sobala, and also Jason Lindgren has already agreed to do a presentation and play music. And I also already booked Chief Crow and the Flat Earthworms to play music because first day is going to be speakers and second day is going to be live music and probably do a live Q&A session too. So it's going to be so much fun. It's going to be awesome. So if you already know you want to go and you already like who's going to be there, I guarantee you're going to like who else is going to be there once it's all said and done. You just go get your ticket now. You get it early. And also the other thing is that the T-shirt for the event is included with the ticket. So when you go buy your ticket, you put your shirt size in and you're good to go for the event. So there you go. It's going to be a good time.
I'm just thrilled. You understand that the last time I went down to Flattoberfest, you know, for the 2021, I had to take an airport shuttle, and I had to wear, because that was public transportation, I had to wear the mask for the entire airport shuttle as well.
Oof.
So, yeah, I know.
Yeah, well, no more of that.
No more of that. Oh, 30 seconds. Okay, so we're going to break, and when we come back, we are going to take your phone calls, 213-233-3998. That's 213-233-3998. Apologies for the truth smacks, the miss on that one. Don't shoot me. And apologies to the late meetup stuff, but I have been distracted. You know, the beginning of the show was, well, you know what the beginning of the show was like.
Yeah.
At least we were on.
Hey, we made it. We
yeah.
made
it. Yeah, we're good. Back in 3 minutes.
This is iHeartRadio.
This is Truth Frequency Radio.
The wicked ones, obviously under heavy Masonic influence.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 3 of 4. It's you, me, and Karen B, and sometimes Peanut Gallery, because he's around there somewhere. Three things I want to mention before we pick up the phone calls, and the phone number to call in is 213-233-3998. That's 213-233-3998. First one is, I forgot about this, although it wasn't on my list of things to do, but I was looking through some stuff. Zulu One's backup channel. So if you're wondering, actually it worked out, talking about prophetic. Zulu said, hey, can you put the promo that you did for, because I did a little video segment for Karen's Flattoberfest last year, where it was a fake ISIS video. Where I pretended, actually somebody else pretended to be a terrorist. I don't know who it was, but he looked a lot like me. And I put it out there, and Zulu said, hey, can you, but I didn't want to put it up because I didn't know if the censors would go after it. But nowadays with the whole Russia thing, nobody apparently cares about ISIS anymore. So If you like that video, if you go to my channel and you look at the Fake ISIS video, there's a link down in the comment section. I pinned it. Zulu, you know, please sub his backup channel if you're wondering why that's there. It's like, well, that's kind of random out of nowhere. I was like, no, it's something I didn't put on my channel because I was so gun shy about getting strikes that I didn't know if it was going to trip the censors. But apparently it hasn't. So great. Wonderful. Second thing, and I put these in chat, but I didn't want to do them in particular order. So the first thing I want to mention really fast, this goes along with the whole Elon Musk thing. So this is something he just said today where he said if he takes over – oh, crap. Did I get a block thing? Darn it. All right. So he said if I take over, basically I'm not going to pay the board members of Twitter. So what I was thinking, it just occurred to me what they're trying to do. They're trying to make him a cross between Tony Stark and Robin Hood. You know what I mean? He's the billionaire that cares, right? Even though I don't know of any philanthropy, I don't know of any charity he's really gung-ho on. The last I heard, he only works for him, you know, thinks of himself. But why would he fire? Basically, why would he pay all the Twitter? So he's going to fire the entire Twitter board. Again, removing censorship, whatever. Bunch of crap. But the headline that also caught my eye was the one, save the tribbles, says Peanut, which is the one up above, which again makes me laugh. This is from Business Insider. Now, follow with me and see where the problem is in this headline. Russia's propaganda machine is so powerful that many Russians don't even realize they're in a disinformation bubble. Said the American media outlet. Russians don't even know it's propaganda, said the United States.
Wow.
We don't do that. We invented that.
Smith Month Act, anyone?
Oh my God.
Good Lord.
Seriously.
They really think that we're all stupid. And unfortunately, a lot of us are.
The three bullet points. I just gotta rattle these off and then I'll pick up some phone calls. The West is urging Russians to find ways to access independent news about the war in Ukraine. Bullet point two. But while some have found success using VPNs, experts say it's not enough to sway public opinion. Number three, you need to understand that before people search, they need to doubt. Said a Russian vlogger. Uh-huh.
Yeah, wow.
If you guys don't know what we're talking about, listen to the first part of the show where we talked about a Russian ship that spontaneously exploded. Then the American media said that the Ukrainians did it, even though they couldn't have done it. It was us. Then the Russians said, oh, no, we got this. It's totally fine. And
it was a weapons fire accident.
Yeah, it was a weapons fire. But we put that out. It's totally fine. We're towing it back to shore, followed by it sunk. Followed by absolutely nothing caused the weird random explosion next to the Britain's Air Force base. It's just a pile of fireworks just exploded. That's what happened.
Boom.
And I love that cover story because you can only use it once. You will never hear another fireworks depot exploding. I know they've got a list of things you can do, but that's the safest one. That one nobody worries about. Because if you say, oh, it was a training exercise, people will ask questions. If you say, oh, it was a ammo depot, people will ask questions. But no. Fireworks thing, it's like, oh, it's fireworks. That's nothing. Just wave it off. Okay, let's pick up some freaking phone calls. All right. Let's go out to New York first. Ready? Here we go. 518, line unmuted. You're on Strange World right now.
Hey, good evening.
Hey.
Karen.
Hey.
Mark, how are you doing this evening?
Good. And I love the fact that you mentioned Karen's name first. That's the smart thing to do.
Absolutely. Absolutely, because, you know, she's a woman of the spectrum. So I have to mention her first. You know what I'm saying? I'm a guard of chivalry. You know, so yes, I have to do that. But
well done. Well done.
Yeah. Yes. First off, this so-called war invasion, or what are you talking about? This is just bankers going after Russia because they came out of their little blocks of things. You know what I'm saying? They're independent, and you know they want to get everybody on board with all the how can I say it?
The Great Reset.
It's like they want to control the world. Now, Russia came out of that. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, right.
So therefore,
go ahead.
So therefore, they want to pull Russia back on board, but Russia's not going back on board. They were switching to rubles. Oh, that's a beautiful thing that Russia is doing, because now they then tied everything to the monetary system.
Yep.
So they did the same thing with Libya. Libya wasn't on board. Libya was about to collapse the whole thing. They had to go in there and get Muammar Gaddafi. And they know that their paper money is worthless. So we're gonna segue to something else.
Okay.
Number two, when they have the they try to vaccinate the world, you see that collapse in a heartbeat because people are getting on board with what they're trying to do. You know, Agenda 21, 2030, they're on board with that. Everybody knows about that. Well, a lot of people don't know, but, you know, we do.
We do. So,
yes, we do. We do know. So therefore, they know that there's a fight to the finish on this. So it's a distraction. That's all that is. It's a distraction to what the mainstream media is not speaking about. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and this is just a realization of things from our perspective, because we know and the universal public don't know, but they're coming on board slowly but surely. But no, we have to put our foot up their asses and let them know this is not happening. You know what I'm saying? One thing I need to know. Okay, check this out. We were talking about flatten the earth, flatten the curve video.
Yeah.
All right. Now, there was a pilot in there named Rob Taylor.
Sure.
I knew about Rob Taylor years ago. He's the one that hit me to Galen Windsor. Remember we talked about this months ago about Galen Windsor the nuclear hoax.
Karen, you know Karen.
I know.
Huh? So
I know.
Yeah, I know you know. Hey. I wish Mark get on fucking board because he's sleeping on this one right here.
All right. I know.
He's sleeping on this one right here.
It's a call-in show. I'd love to keep talking to you. I really would. What do shout outs.
I wish you would, but that's okay. It's okay.
I know.
So I'm gonna call it next week and we can expound on Galen Windsor. But you need to get
7-11.
You want to?
Oh, I just missed it.
Huh? Oh,
that's all right. Keep going.
But okay. Let's see. Sean Hitler. is coming out with the next level on Friday.
Okay.
I think you better get on that one. I mean, like,
all right.
I know you like Eric, but
no,
he drops some good content. He drops good content.
All right. Hey, so, before I let you go, I gotta ask. What is your beverage of choice this evening?
Oh, I'm sipping on some Parmesan brandy.
All right. Just checking. But yes, all right. Hey, we will talk to you again soon. And thank you for calling in. And I cut him off. Just because I got to move on. It's a call-in show, guys. I gotta do this. Sorry, I don't want to be mean or anything like that. But
no, it's fine. It's okay.
No, I mean, you know it is with flat earthers. I mean, we will talk forever. You know, we'll just talk and like, you gotta remember.
Oh, I know.
There's other people in line. I mean, how fast you know the time went. You know, and next thing you know, I'm looking down. It's like, holy smokes, I've been talking to Steph for 8 hours. It's a long time. Are you jealous yet, Karen?
I am jealous that you got to hang out with Stefan like all day.
See if you can run into him. I guarantee he's going to be to Atlanta the day before. See if you can pull that off. If anyone can, you can.
Even if he could, I don't know that I could go out there a day early because I have a house with critters and animals and things, and it's just like.
Are you sure this is your chance? This he likes you more than he likes me.
Well, I don't know about that.
I know about that. You and he are cut from the same freaking cloth. I'm not kidding you. After spending time with him, now I get it. It's like, hope if Karen and he actually sit in the same room next to each other, the universe will probably implode. To the sound of guitars.
This is going to be lightning bolts shooting out everywhere.
It will. It'll be like, holy smoke. All right, let's go back out to New York. 646, line unmuted. What's happening out there?
I don't know. What are you doing?
Oh, God. You know, for a New Yorker, you're awfully low-key sometimes. It's like you were you born in California sometimes. Or were you born in New York?
No, he's not from New York originally, remember?
I was born in the wilderness, man. In the wilderness.
To Kansas.
I only moved out here, like... Kansas. I'm a Kansas boy, man. I mean, you had my old fucking Kansas City number, dude. I've been talking to you for fucking years. Come on, dude. You know
yeah, that
shit.
Doesn't mean anything. I've got a Colorado number, and I'm not from Colorado.
I know. I was just too lazy to change my number, really, but, you know, whatever.
Oh, me
I
too.
I mean, I was just like...
No, me too. Once...
I'm having kind of a...
Because I... Go ahead.
I don't know. I was just saying, like, you know, I still like my number. I don't care. I don't have, like, an attachment to, like, the digits on my phone or anything. It's like some people in New York are like, I have a 917 number. Nah. Well, I have a 646 number. Well, my 646 number is a fucking Google number. Well, fuck you. Like, whatever. Like, bitch. I don't care. Anyway, that's all I have to say about that.
By the way, I have caught myself listening to your very catchy song now that I have attached at the end of the Strange World episodes on when they're out on BitChute and Variety. On when I build the show, I put that song at the end after the credits. So if people are stay long enough to listen to that, and all of a sudden rolls. It's a rocking song. I dig it, man.
Look at that, Lowry.
Thank
you got
you.
A fan.
Thank
Mark's
you.
A fan.
I do. I am a fan.
Thank
and
you.
I like a.
I'm glad that
I like
I'm
a
glad
lot of stuff.
You
but
like it. I mean.
Seriously, the first time
it was
I
good heard, though he did
it
good
was
job.
Good. First time I heard it, I was going, "Wow, this is really some good stuff." I had no idea.
Thank you. Did you know I have another side band going too? It's called Flat, P H L A T, Flat.
Really?
You heard about that one?
No.
Yeah, that's happening right now. I've got fucking really great people to play with this band. We're not really going to jam. I guess
band?
We could jam, but it would be linear. It would be mostly linear. It'd be like a linear
is Griff
jam.
In that band with you? Alex. Alex. is Griff in the band?
Yes, he is. Yes. Griff and like the guy that has the drummer. I can't fucking remember his damn fucking name, but I know him. The tinfoil hat. Not the tinfoil hat. I don't care. It doesn't matter. Fuck it. he's really good. And then I've got a... What's the name? You know it? I don't know.
No. Hey, Peanut Gallery wants me to
tinfoil
hat. Move on
to tinfoil hat. No. I'm not done yet. I have one more thing to say.
You heard him, Peanut.
A mutual friend of ours. I'm not going to say the name or their name. Very lovely friends of both of ours. Actually got a Tesla whatever it's called in their attic.
Model S.
They have a Tesla thing in their attic. I just learned that tonight. I'm giggling about it. And they sent
some pictures. Oh, they got a Tesla coil in their attic?
They have a Tesla coil in their attic. And nice. It's awesome. And you know the guy. I mean, there's only Griff says, stop drinking, Alex. Dude, I can drink. It's Tuesday night. I drink every time. I'm looking at the chat right now. Anyway, no, I'll just do I'll do some shout outs because, yeah, I've had a few drinks myself. Is that what you wanted from me?
Yeah, I did. And tell me what you're drinking.
I'm just having a nice little IPA and just thinking through, like, you know, some really great linear jams that we could do with flat pH. L-A-T. Shout out to Crumb, Spicy Griff, Bex, Dottie and Company, Marty Leeds, Morgyle. I forgot a lot of people in my film, so I'm like, I'm trying to get them all in. Morgyle, D-I-T-R-H, he was in there. Captain Flattastic, Mellow Dome and Realm, Christian Knapp, Austin. Christian's also going to be in flat, too. That's it. Love you guys. Right. Bye.
All right. See you, man.
Awesome.
All right, let's go out to, funny enough, Kansas City. 913, line unmuted. What's happening out there?
What's going on, Mark?
Hey.
Hey, Mark.
Hey.
Can you hear me?
Mark? Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
I can hear you now. All right.
Okay.
What's going on?
Oh, you know, Tuesday night.
Hi.
What's happening?
Well, you know, I've been listening to you for a couple of years now. This is the first time I called. I started out with Rob Skiba. Listening to him, I was going through the Book of Enoch. Are you familiar with that at all?
I believe I've got a copy sitting over in a drawer somewhere. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and so I started with that, and then flat Earth crap started coming up on my feed on the computer and my phone, and so I started looking into that, and then you came around. I started looking at all your stuff, and it just kind of changed my world. It's just crazy stuff. I couldn't believe it, and then
cool.
It came out to the point where it all made so much sense, you know?
Yeah.
And so, I guess, so me and my wife, we went to Florida. We took a flight to Florida and I brought a little, torpedo level with me. And I had it on my little tray in front of me going through, you know, as we were flying and stuff. So we got up to level when they were flying.
And did it move at any point?
No. And so it was always a little higher. So it always seemed like it was a little high. And I'm not sure if it was listening to you or just somebody else that they said that the airplane itself is always – the tip of the nose is always a little higher because of the airstream and lifting up, and so it has to be that way. And the only time it tipped down was when we were descending into the airport.
Right on.
And so let me step back a little. As we're getting onto the plane, one of the stewardesses said to us that I had a gator instead of a mask. And so, you know what the gators are?
Are they not allowed anymore?
Well,
yeah. Oh, no, I bought a whole bunch of gators for this. Yeah, I like gators.
Yeah. Yeah, so I was using the gate, and my wife had a mask on. And as we were walking into the plane, one of the stewards said that the mask Nazi was in the back, so be careful. And so we went back in there, and sure enough, we got to our seat, and he helped us in, and he told me that, well, you can't do that. You have to have a mask, so he got me a mask. And anyway, so we went through the flight, and toward the end of the flight, I had my torpedo level on there, and then that one stewardess from the very beginning, she came back, and we were chit-chatting a little bit, and she said, oh, yeah, it's definitely flat. We all know that. So she was talking about her, the stewardesses, and the pilots. She said, yeah, we know that. It's just all flat. There's no curvature at all.
Yeah. One of my favorite things, stay with me for a minute. One of my favorite stories is when I came back from the UK the second time, and I bounced off. I was flying Iceland Air, and I bounced off Reykjavik and came down to Seattle. And when I landed, I was in customs, and I was sitting there with my bag. We're waiting for stuff, the bags to come off to finally go through customs. And one of the pilots walked up to me. And he goes, hey, I really like your stuff. Can I get a selfie taken with you? And I go, huh? And I go, who are you? And he goes, oh, I flew you here. I go, what? He goes, yeah. He goes, I'm really into your stuff. And I go, that's awesome. And he goes, yeah. And he takes a selfie, shakes my hand, talks for just a minute. And then he quietly goes back to his group of pilots over there. And I guarantee he not say anything to them. I'm sure they'd be like, who's that guy? Oh, just some guy I knew, blah, blah, blah. You know, I was the friend in high school that it's like not apparently friends with other people. So, yeah. A lot of pilots know. Yeah. Absolutely.
You know, no question. You know, you don't want a whole lot of people to know about it.
Yeah. Well, again, you know, if you're a pilot, you can't really talk about it. You know, there was that wonderful, wonderful woman pilot from KLM who got benched because she did talk about it. And, good for her. Very, very, very brave. But
yeah. Okay. Yeah. I heard you talking to her and about that. Yeah. And so she, this stewardess, anyway, she was just saying that they know that, and so I ended up giving her your name and your website and stuff, and so
cool.
You know, maybe
thank you.
She'll hear you talking someday and give you a call and talk to you about it. So anyway, so the Flat Earth Conference that's in October.
Yes, October. In Spartanburg?
Yes. No. It's in Greenville. It's back in Greenville this year. Greenville and Spartanburg are only about a half an hour away from each other, but it's back in Greenville this year at the Shrine Club.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Karen B., where are you from?
I originally from California.
Oh, okay. Do you mind if I ask you where you living now?
North Carolina.
Oh, okay. All right. So I was wondering if you were in that area. Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's why I have it here, because it's right near me and it's easy.
okay.
She's using conference privilege. Hey, do some shout outs for me, because we're going to music.
Oh, well, you know, I don't have any shout outs, but, you know, God bless you all. And
all right.
Keep it flat, man.
All right, thanks, man. We'll talk soon. And while we're going to music, what he meant to say was, always shout out Mark and Karen. Or Karen and Mark. Probably Karen and Mark.
Real people, real radio.
Initiating the Truth Frequency.
This is Truth Frequency Radio.
Welcome back to Strange World, part four. It's you, me, and Karen B. And I did not realize, by the way, that you were streaming on YouTube.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I did not know. And the only reason I knew that is because it was recommended to me on my right-hand side when I was doing a search for, funny thing, USSR television sign-off, which I'm going to include part of that in the beginning and the end of some of my repeats. I love the... that, you know, because they did this, they did something different. You know, back in the day, before you, Karen, back in the day when television did not run 24 hours a day, we had a sign off at the end, and they didn't just do a national anthem. It was a big scrolling thing of everything that was great about the USSR. It might as well have been a promo from Rocky IV. And at the very end, it was really cool. The end, they actually flashed a thing with a beeping sound that said, "Don't forget to turn off your TV." Because how many people in Gen X, you know, fell asleep and then all of a sudden they woke up and it was just a salt and pepper fight on the screen and, you know, just a big static channel. So that was kind of cool. Okay. By the way, what's happening in chat? Am I supposed to, should I even be looking in there?
I wouldn't look in chat right now. It's kind of a mess.
Okay.
I would just stay out of there.
Is there some troll trouble? Is there some troll thing happening?
You know.
Or is it just infighting?
Sometimes the live chat has nothing to do with what is going on in the show.
Mm,
today is one of those days.
All right. I respect that. All right. Let's find some phone calls. Let's go out to Illinois. 779, line unmuted. You're on Strange World. Impress us. With silence. Love it. All right, 779. I know you were probably muting or sleeping or whatever. Let's go back out to California. It's 562. Line unmuted. You are on Strange World. The Karen B. Show, really.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey. Jesus, man. I've been on hold forever over here, man.
You've been on hold for 35 minutes. I wouldn't complain. We've had people go twice and three times that long.
Man, everybody's been blabbing over here. I'm like, hurry up and let me get my turn, man. Jesus. I'm just bullshitting you guys. It's all good. Man, a couple things. Yeah, this is Tone. I'm out here in California. But, yeah, I met you at one of the L.A. meetups when they were filming the thing. And I got to meet you real quick. And
cool.
I said something to the effect, like, how does it feel to be flat earth famous or some shit? And you were like, oh, I'll take it. But you're a real cool dude, real humble and genuine. You know, so when people
Thank
always
you.
Say, like, you're a shill or something, I'm like, man, you know, he just seems kind of like a nerdy-ass dude. Like, I mean, I don't get it, so, but real
Thanks,
cool.
Thanks, man.
Karen, I really like you, too. I like how you, like, don't put up with nobody's bullshit. That's awesome.
Thank you.
Like, yeah, you don't let them off the hook at all. You're like, fuck that. Nope. A couple things. So, you know, I used to live in Long Beach for the last 20 years, but I moved out here to like Temecula, Marietta now. And anyway, that's why I always listen to the show and I never get a chance to call in. And I'm like, fuck that, I'm going to call in right now. And then I was on hold for 35 minutes. But anyway, man, a couple weeks ago, you were talking about people. No, I know. It's all good, man. You're a hot commodity. Man, so a couple weeks ago, you were talking about people that passed away, and you brought up the singer Khalees's husband. You remember that or no?
I'll say yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway,
that was a while ago. That was a while ago.
Wait, maybe how long ago? Like a month or so ago, or longer than that?
Yeah, about at least a month. Yeah.
Okay, no biggie. Anyway, I got a funny story with that, and I'm not trying to gossip or anything, but I actually did a job for her at her home probably back in November, and I actually got to meet her husband, and, you know, I didn't really know who he was or anything, but he was nice, and I didn't realize it was Khalees at the time when I was at her house. I didn't realize till, like, afterwards. Anyway, sure. The dude, yeah, he was younger than me, and... you know, he looked kind of sick back then, too. And I'm like, whoa, what's going on? So when you announced that, it was kind of trippy. Like, oh, shit, man, that's crazy that I got to meet that guy. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
And I was just back there at her house like about a week ago, or no, not a week ago, a couple days ago. She was getting ready for a big like Easter celebration. And obviously they're gonna do a celebration for him, but it was pretty trippy, man.
Huh? Small world.
So anyway, quick question for Karen, real quick. I'm just kind of curious. Karen, do you make some of those beats that you put in your videos, or no?
Make some of the what?
Like the beats? The music.
The music?
Yeah.
No, I purchase them.
Okay. Yeah, I was just kind of wondering. I was like, oh, maybe she's a musician or something, because they're kind of like more like trappy hip hop style beats.
Yeah, I
not
like
all
that
of them,
stuff.
But some of
that's
them.
That's why I pick it. Yeah, I like that stuff. I did make a couple of beats for my very first video, but it was so time consuming that I never did it again.
Right. Yeah. Totally. Well. Listen. So I do make beats and music, and
What happened to him?
Before him and Austin, fell apart or whatever. So a lot of my music has been in those videos. But anyway, I want to make a beat for you, and I want to you use it whenever you can. And I'll get in touch with you somehow, some way when I finally get one to you.
All right. Well, I put my email out on all my streams, so you can email me that. It's also on my website.
I'll find it. Yeah, I've been talking with Jaren too about it, and I got to shoot him a beat too. But one of these days, I'll finally get that shit done and get it to y'all.
Awesome.
What else was I gonna say? One last thing. Oh, and I told Jaren too, and I extend the offer to anybody. But you know, I'm pretty good at audio editing, mixing, and shit like that. A lot of these videos that come out, I fucking hate the audio is just shitty. Like especially like the flatten the curve one. I know everybody's complaining about it, but I really wish I could have took that audio and fixed it. You know what I mean? To where it was like more manageable. You know. Because it kind of turns you off. You're like, bro, I don't want to listen to this shit. You know what I mean? But I want to hear it.
Oh, I hear you.
Anyway, I'll reach out to you guys or whatever. I'll let somebody, who's been waiting longer than I have get back on here. But I'm glad I finally got in touch with you guys, and I'll reach out to you when I finally got some shit together.
All right. Awesome.
Right on.
All right, guys. Take it easy, and I'll talk to you.
Okay. Have a good one.
All right. Yeah,
you
too.
Yep. Yeah. Longtime listener and almost never calls. So cool. Let's go out to your neck of the woods. Greenville, South Kakalaki, 864. Line unmuted.
Hey. Hey, Marky Mark and the Karen Bunch. How's it going?
Hey.
Good. What's going on?
It's actually, I'm in Spartanburg, so right next door. Kind of bummed the conference is going to be, I guess, like a half hour from me. Otherwise, I could probably like just like skateboard to or jog to it if it was downtown again. But
you're complaining because you can't skateboard to the conference? Really?
That's right. Yeah, while everybody else is traveling hundreds of miles, I'm complaining about,
yeah, I was about to say,
like 20 miles.
It's an all-day thing for me, but go ahead. Complain about that. Seriously.
I wanted to say you can tell Elon is for real because he sounds so fake.
There you go.
You're talking earlier about,
no, you know what? I'm gonna follow that up with it looks so fake because it is so fake. People know the story, and that is when I got a link, I got a little snapshot of the Roadster in space in my email that morning. And I was me. It's like, who made that? They go, Jaren made that. Who made that? Who made that shot? And then somebody wrote back, go, no, dude, that's a link. That's a live stream. I'm going, the what? It can't be a live stream.
Some of the beginning of your YouTube videos looks like way more real than that, with John Travolta up in space and everything. The Pulp Fiction in space.
Seriously, the movie Gravity is infinitely more realistic than the Roadster in space, but whatever. He's a fraud, and hopefully he'll get his in the end.
Hey, let me ask you guys, where is the chat these days? So it used to be on TFR, and then it was on Zulu's channel. Like, where's the chat you guys are always talking about?
Well, right Go ahead, Karen.
Well, the chats would be on my live stream feed, and I have actually a few streams going. I multi-stream, so I stream on Rockfin, Twitch, and Facebook usually, and then tonight I just started streaming back on YouTube again for the first time in a very long time because they were nailing us left and right there for a long time. So,
awesome. Those are the okay. chats. Yeah, the party keeps moving around, so okay, cool. I must have missed that. Awesome. So I wanted to, something else I want to talk to you guys about, and this is kind of out there. I was listening to like an old Bob Lazar interview, and I can hear your eyeballs rolling. So
no.
But
no.
I was listening.
No, it's fine.
Okay. All right. So it was Bob Lazar, and he was talking to Joe Rogan. I think it's from a couple of years back, and I thought, you know, like, so taking Flat Earth into account, like, puts this whole different lens on the way, you know, we used to think of this UFO stuff as like, oh, that's so cool. And now I think it's largely bullshit, right? And, you know, so we're always, like, looking at it with this, you know, huge dose of, like, you know, huge, you know, 50-pound bag of salt, you know, taking it with that. So, but yeah. I started to think, like, you know, with the Flat Earth lens added to it, he was talking about how he went and he was working on this UFO, and it was built for somebody about, like, 3'10", right? And I'm suspending disbelief for a minute. I'm like, well, if he's not totally full of shit, it's possible that, you know, he did do this, right? But the thing is, the government, and he mentions this several times, they'll only tell you what you need to know to work on these secret projects, right? It's very segmented, need to know basis. And so it's, so I'll follow up on that in a second. But one of the things that stood out to me is he said there was no screens in this device. It was, it seemed to be all analog, right? Well, as far as they could tell. I mean, they couldn't crack it open to find out how it was working. Apparently, it was making people sick every time they tried to work on it.
Yeah, yeah.
But there was no screens, right? And, you know, every vehicle we have now has screens in it, right? So, and you would think an advanced technology would have screens. So, and he also mentioned, you know how Tesla, you're speaking about Tesla earlier, you know, was going to make this electricity that was going to be free to everyone. Bob Lazar mentioned that if that had actually went through, that small microchips would not have worked. It would burn out before you could ever actually put them in these vehicles, or we would never have, we'd never even have computers. So you wouldn't have screens. So I thought that was pretty interesting. And then I started thinking about the Iron Republic. And I could be, correct me if I'm wrong, but were there any screens in that story or was it, you know, because I know their news came through the radio. It was like a radio broadcast. I don't even think they had separate channels.
That's a good question. And yeah, I think there is some give and take when it comes to technology. There are certain technologies that prohibit other technologies. It's a trade-off. So he was right. And I don't want to dig in too much into Lazar, but he was right in that sense. Whereas if Tesla had succeeded with that, the early Colorado experiments about generating electric, you know, transmitting electricity free to people through the air, like wireless, delicate circuitry would have a really, really tough time with that.
Yes.
I don't want to condemn too much of what he said. The thing that saves Bob is that Groom Lake is a real place. That's the only thing that really saves him. Mm-hmm. You know, if Groom Lake, if the Area 51 facility did not exist as some giant Air Force base that we reverse engineer crap at, then he wouldn't have a leg to stand on. It's just that it's worked very well for him because he can say whatever he wants and he can embellish anything he wants, and no one from you can't go there to confirm or deny anything. So it's great. Was he there at one point? Yeah, maybe. But who can? Yeah. No one can come out and officially say one way or the other. So
fine. I mean, they claim, you know, this has been an ongoing story for 30 years, and he's been validated. Like, you know, that cesium didn't exist. You know, the element, whatever number it was, and didn't exist until recently. You know, and he was talking about it before. Again, I'm taking it with a bag of salt here, but. Something I wanted to kind of tie it in with the Flat Earth a little bit, though, which I thought was really cool. So I've been looking into this Tartarian stuff a whole lot. And, you know, they're talking about how they lived the World's Fair with all these lights, and there was really no wiring involved. So, it's, you know, a lot of speculation here. But a lot of people, when they talk about the Tartarians, they say that they didn't have, you know, all this circuitry and wires to connect everything together. So again, I'm wondering if there's a parallel technology that, that came up this alongside, you know, well, not, I don't want to say alongside ours, but before ours, where that's, they didn't have screens, you know, they didn't have computers, but they did have this wireless energy. And then I start to think, so if the Iron Republic story is right, okay, at the time the guy traveled there in the 20s, right, and they were about 100 years ahead of us in technology, so about our level today, right, minus the screens, okay. So then I'm wondering, right, like, is Bob Lazar actually working on like a giant child's toy, like a Barbie play car for an Iron Republican? You know, like in the government, maybe, like maybe it used to have pink paint on it and they took it off, like it was like a kid crash landed here from over the wall. Like, you know, wouldn't that be crazy?
That would be crazy.
They just removed the pony stickers and everything.
No, I mean, I'm not going to dismiss it because weirder things have happened. My favorite.
I mean, if you took a Barbie play car and you dropped it off in like 18, you know, like you know, the 1850s or whatever, people would be like baffled, right? They'd be like, "What is this? There's a battery. It's made out of some strange material. You know, we call it plastic, right?" So maybe that's what happened. Maybe in the 1950s, a UFO which came from over the ice wall landed. And that's what it was, you know, but sure, it was like a kid's toy.
Anything, so. anything along those lines. I mean, you could have taken a speak and spell from the early 1980s and that just blow people's minds. Anyway, love it. Love all that stuff. Hey, you got any shout outs? Because it's a call in show and I got to grab some.
Shout out to Mark and Karen B and any Iron Republicans that made it to the inner territories. Give me a shout.
Nice.
This is Devin, the developer. Thanks, Mark.
Nice. Thank you very much. And by the way, if anybody from the Iron Republic is listening right now, send me an email. Seriously, I would love to. I love that story. I do. I don't know. I mean, there might be variations of it that are real. I love the idea of continents being outside of ours. If there's a way, you know, through the maze to get there, I love it. All right, got time for maybe a couple more. Let's go to, where are we going? All right, let's do Dan. No, you know what? We're going to go down here first. We're going to pick up 214, line unmuted. We will take you and then we'll take New York. What's happening?
Unmuted, right?
No, you're not muted, Jan.
Oh, I really wish that thing could get fixed. I'm trying to remember when... When you were in New Zealand, how many years ago was that?
3 years ago? Yeah, it sounds about right.
Oh, okay. And I believe that you were having a birthday at that time, right? April 24th?
Was I having a birthday? Was I there for my birthday
in
New Zealand? I'm going to have to look. You know what? Wow, good memory, Jan. You're absolutely right. I celebrated my birthday while I was on the plane. Wow. Thank you. I completely zoned out.
Good memory, Jan.
Yeah, wonderful. Why do you bring that up, Jan?
Because of this Sunday.
Damn it. Thank you, Jan. Yes, my birthday is coming up this Sunday before the show. So you don't have to do any birthday thing for me now. If anyone's out there, you don't have to mail me anything right now. My birthday isn't until Sunday. But yes, thank you for remembering, Jan. That is awfully sweet.
Well, you're quite a special man, and it's fun to remember those things. And so anyway, just best to you on Sunday. Hope you have a wonderful day, and say goodbye to you and I've had a bit of a drink. Karen and Tina.
Okay,
what are you, Jan? What are you drinking before I let you go?
Cavassier.
Wow.
Yeah. Aren't we fancy?
Everybody's drinking brandy, Cavassier. They're way fancy tonight. I didn't get the memo that it was fancy drink night.
I know, right? As I hear the empty can slammed down in Karen's office. Oh, well, thank you, Jan. That's awful. That's awfully sweet. That's absolutely.
You're welcome.
And to be honest, I got to be honest, actually, until you had said that, I'm looking at the calendar to my left. I was going, What's so special about the, oh, right, I have a birthday coming up. Sorry, once you get to a certain age, you don't look forward to them. You kind of push them out of your mind, and it's like, oh, wow.
Sometimes I forget how old I am. I'm like, was it 44, 43, 40? I don't remember.
Yeah. Now I'm more stories I hear about Gen Z. It's like, well, you know, the middle of Gen Zers are 18 now, and I'm going, what? It's like, that's not good. Yeah, thank you, Peanut, for that. All right. Anyway, Jan, any last words before I send you off back into your Calvacier zone?
Oh, I'm still here. Oh no, yes. Thank you though. But a shout out to Dottie. Haven't heard from her in a while. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, Jan. We'll talk soon. Okay. Oh, she's so nice. I completely forgot about my birthday. Okay. I actually forgot. It's like, wait, it's before the next show. Wow. Okay, let's pick up. Okay, here we go. 845, line unmuted. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. With Truth Smacks, Trail Supreme. There it is.
You are the dancing queen, young and sweet, only 17, dancing queen. Sorry, I'm from Finland.
I wasn't kidding.
They looked
like a freaking ABBA reunion tour, those two, on stage.
Dude, I've been fucking waiting all night to say that. Oh, my God.
Thank you.
Fucking kill
Thank
me.
You.
You are killing
did you
me.
Did you have to look ABBA. Up the lyrics, by the way? Do you have the lyrics in front of you?
Of course. Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. Of course.
Yeah.
Come on. Do you think I would know those? Come on. Oh, my God. Hi, Karen. Hi, Mark. How are you?
I'm good. When I was in Sweden, one of the cab drivers, they bow down to ABBA out there. I mean, they were the greatest thing that ever hit that country. And even now, you know, because they're all still alive, as far as I know,
it's so weird.
Yeah, it's just a weird part of their culture. And, you know, because it's so recent in comparison to, I don't know, everything else that's Swedish. Anyway, what's happening with you?
Yeah. Hey, I got a couple things. First, happy birthday. I remembered it's the same day as my mother's. Crazy. I'll never forget that. That's so weird. Happy birthday. Do Ukrainians have a navy? Huh?
I thought they
were landlocked.
No, that's the whole point of
Ukraine.
Okay,
I'm clueless then.
They All own right. huge tracts of real estate on the Black Sea. But to your point, they had a navy.
Two months
ago they had a navy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's bad.
That was a bullshit ship thing. I swear, that looked like some old fucking 80s era ship that they were like, oh, we'll blow it up. We'll tell both sides that each side blew it up and we'll make a fucking story. That just seems so fake.
That whole fucking thing. You're right on both cases. The ship, by the way, which was retrofitted, was initially built in 1979. So you're absolutely right. It was a new ship. I mean, it is a USSR ship. However, the stories from both sides of the fence. They're, you know, both, one side's trying to save face, the other trying to take credit for it, even though they can't take credit for it. And yeah, both sides. Yeah, but the point is, Russia isn't playing ball. They're not doing it. It's like, yeah, you want to blow up a ship? Fine, we do other things to you.
I think the Finland thing is a bigger chess piece. That's a bigger chess piece.
Yeah.
To play that role, and like you said, that ipso facto whatever shuts them right the fuck down as soon as they invade them.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
they're not going into NATO. They're not going to be part of NATO.
Yeah, you can't join NATO if there's an occupying force in your country. Period. They won't do it. It looks bad. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, so I'm picking you up then, Flatoverfest.
Oh boy. Yeah.
Airport.
Probably.
Probably. All right.
So
we're
gonna have to do our buddy cop. We'll have to get our buddy cop lines down.
This time we'll film it. This time we'll film it, and I'll be sober.
Awesome.
Yeah,
that's great.
I promise.
Hey, you've got about 60 seconds till we roll out, so whatever else you got.
All right, cool. I'm drinking snake water liqueur, by the way. And they're fucked up. Here in New York, they're still doing the mask thing. It's going until the end of May. All the arts, you can't go to the theaters and shit and on Broadway without wearing masks and stuff. They're ridiculous. It's so crazy. And I can't believe you, Mark. You're absolutely right. No deep kissing.
No, dude. And I'm a big kissing fan. I'm from the old. I'm Gen
I
X.
Hear
I'm
you.
From the
I'm not
the
saying I know
days.
Anything about that.
You know, it's like let's go to the back seat of the car and make out for 3 hours.
Right.
So.
And that sign off shit that used to be at midnight, then it was at 2 a.m. and then TV was just 24 hours a day. I totally remembered watching that shit. Yep. Yeah.
Oh, hey. Hey, same flat time, same flat channel. Say goodnight, Karen.
Goodnight, Karen.
Say goodnight, Zulu.
Goodnight, Zulu.
And what's that? Hot sex. Thanks to everybody in chat.
Hot sex.
Hot sex. Happy birthday,
Shout
Mark.
Shout out to everybody.
Thank you. Good night, everybody.
Happy birthday, Mark.
You'll ever need.